Let's continue our look deeper into matrices. And I'm going to talk to you today about elementary matrices. You might have seen those. That is what is used to solve systems of linear equations, to get to reduced row echelon form, or at least row form. And this is in preparation of something called LU decomposition of a matrix, lower upper. And we'll talk about what a lower triangular and upper triangular matrix is in the next video. But today we're going to concentrate on elementary matrices. How do we get to reduced row echelon form or just echelon form? Now I'm going to cheat again by just creating a system of linear equations, two equations and two unknowns, and I'm going to let x equals 2 and y equals 1. I plug that in with some coefficients. I see what the solution is so that I have the system of equations to work with, and I know that x must be 2 and y must be 1. And from that, I have created my augmented matrix here. Let's call this augmented matrix A. A, it's my augmented matrix. Now, what would we do to this is we see that we need a zero in this position. How would we do that? Well, I would take minus a quarter times the first row and add that to the second row, because minus a quarter times 4 is minus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0, and I'll get a 0 there. But let me do something very special. Let me start with the identity matrix. And the identity matrix, as far as a 2 by 2 matrix is concerned, would be 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. And let's see what I would have done here. I would have said minus a quarter times row 1 added to row 2. Let's do that to the identity matrix. Minus a quarter times row 1, which will leave this at minus a quarter, and minus a quarter times 0, that's 0, and I'm going to add that to row 2. And that is going to be my what I call my first elementary matrix, and I'm going to write that as E. So minus a quarter, so I'm still having 0 and 1 in the first row, but for the second row it's going to be minus a quarter times the first row, so that's minus a quarter, plus 0, that leaves me with minus a quarter. Minus a quarter times the first row, that's still 0, plus my 1 gives me 1. And I'm going to call this my first elementary matrix. And let's do the following here. Let's do E1 times A. Will that work? Well, this is 2 by 2, and this is 2 by 3. 2 by 2 times 2 by 3, that's going to work, leaving me with a 2 by 3 matrix. And this is exactly what we are doing when we are doing this elementary row operation. So your elementary matrices start with the identity matrix, and we're going to apply an elementary row operation to it. So let's do that. So we have, remember, 1 and 0, and negative a quarter and 1, and I'm going to multiply that by 4, minus 2, and a 6, and a 1, and a 3, and a 5, so that I can get this matrix 1, 2, 3 columns, 1, 2, 2 rows, and 3 columns. So it ends up as 2 by 3, exactly what I want. So just look at what happens if I take this one and multiply by this. It's 4 plus 0 is 4. That's minus 2. That's 6. It leaves that first row absolutely where it needs to be. And that is what we would have done if we just did the elementary row operation in the second one. Let's do this. Minus a quarter, so that gives me minus 1 plus 1 is 0, which is exactly what I want. Minus a quarter times minus 2, that's a half. Plus 3, that's 3 and a half. That leaves me 7 over 2. And minus a quarter times 6, so let's just do that. Minus 6 over 4, and that gives me minus 6 over 4, plus 5, and 5, that's 20 over 4, that gives me 14 over 4, that gives me 7 over 2. So 7 over 2. And that is exactly what we would have done if we had just done normal row operations here. And what we did, in actual fact, is create an elementary matrix from the identity matrix by doing exactly to it what we would have done with Gauss-Jordan elimination here. We had one of the elementary row operations minus a quarter times row 1 plus row 2. And that's exactly what we do to the identity matrix, and we multiply it. So now we sit with the following matrix. We have 4 minus 2 and 6 and 0 and 7 over 2 and 7 over 2. What would we do in the following way? As I said, I don't like fractions, but to create these. Now, these elementary matrices, they are not going to be, they're not going to be unique. You can do a variety of things here. Don't have to follow the exact same steps. So if you follow other steps, your elementary matrices will look different. But what I would do here is just multiply row 2 by 2 over 7. That will give me a 1 and a 1 so that I have a leading 1 here, which is what I want. So if I start with the identity matrix, if I were to start with the identity matrix and I multiply row 2 by 2 over 7, that'll give me my second 1. So that's still a 1 and a 0. And I multiply by 2 over 7. That's 0 there and 2 over 7 there. That's my E2. And let's do that. Let's now do E2 times this E1A. And we have 0, 1, 0, 2 over 7. And we have our matrix there, 4 minus 2 and 6, and 0 and 7 over 2 and 7 over 2. And what are we going to get? Exactly the same in the first row. And here we're going to get 0, 1, 1. As I multiply these and these, I get 0, 1, 1. So there's my new matrix. Let's just clean the board here a little bit. So now we're left with 4 minus 2 and 6 and 0, 1, 1. Now we can already do back substitution because this says 4 times x minus 2y equals 6 and 1y equals 1, so y equals 1, and it's exactly there. I can plug that in and I can solve that. But let's carry on. Let's carry on with these. Let's just clean the board a little bit more. There we go, a bit more space. So what would I do to this? To get a leading 1 here, I would multiply row 1 by a quarter. So that's a quarter times row 1. Let's do exactly that to the identity matrix, which gives me 3, which is a quarter, 0, 0, 1. And let's do this E3 then times my E3 times my E2, E1A. And let's do that so that it's going to be a quarter, 0, 0, 1. And I'm multiplying it by 4 minus 2, 6, and then 0, 1, 1. That gives me a 1. That gives me minus a half. And that gives me 6 over 4, which is 3 over 2. 0, 1, 1. So that's where I am at the moment. Let's put that there. So that gives me 1 minus a half and 3 over 2. And all I need to do, I can stop here again with back substitution, but let's get to reduced row echelon form. And so what would I do to get rid of that half? Well, I'll multiply row 2, so it's a half times row 2, plus row 1. If I have a half times row 2, that will give me a half plus negative a half, which give me a 0. That's what I want there. And that is what my E4 is going to be. So it's a half times row 2, so that's a 0 and a half. So that means, and am I adding that to row 1? So 0 plus 1, so that's still a 1. And 0 plus a half, that's a half. And at the bottom, I have still 0 and 1. So let's do that on this side. So we're going to do E4 multiplied by this E3, E2, E1A that I've got at the moment. And that is 0. And that is 1 and a half, 0 and 1. And we're going to multiply that by 1 minus a half, 3 over 2, 0, 1, 1. Let's do that. 1 times 1, that leaves me with a 1. 1 times negative a half plus a half. Negative half plus a half is 0. And you have 3 over 2 plus a half, that's 4 over 2, that leaves me with 2. And here I still have 0, 1, 1. If I multiply this 0, this 1, this still a 1. And there is my solution. X equals 2 and y equals 1. X equals 2 and y equals 1. So we know we are correct there. So what we've done is this, creating the series of elementary matrices. And those elementary matrices is just what I wanted to do. The elementary row operation I do to an identity matrix, which I then multiply by A. So if I were to get this E4, E3, E2, E1, if I were to do that multiplication and multiply it by A, I was going to get to reduced row echelon form. And it is these elementary matrices that are going to be important. We've already seen they're important in solving systems of linear equations, but they're also going to be important when we do LU decomposition, lower upper triangular decomposition of a matrix, and that is also used for solving these systems, for getting the inverses of a matrix, and for getting to the determinant of a matrix, and we'll still discuss the determinant. So I hope you understand. It is just, it's very intuitive. What the elementary row operation we wanted to do is what we do to the identity matrix to create this. Every elementary operation, elementary matrix that you see here is taking the identity matrix and applying an elementary row operation to it. Please be careful when you do it in the beginning. Where the pitfalls are that you've got to be aware is when I say a half times row 2 plus row 1, so a half times row 2 plus row 1, that means I'm changing row 1. I'm changing row 1, leaving row 2 exactly where it was. So just be careful what you do. It's not that this is now 0 and a half here. It is 1, as I'm changing row 1. It's a half times row 2 plus row 1. So it's a change of row 1, not of row 2. Here was a change of row 2, not row 1. A change of row 2, not row 1. A change of row 2, not row 1. So just be careful which one you do there. So do a few of those just to make absolutely sure that this is, you know, that you do this correctly, so that you do. And it's only through practice that you're going to get this right. So say these are relatively pointless exercises on paper, but most of you will have to do that for your exams, and it becomes important when we just want to have a look at LU decomposition, which is something we will do tomorrow. We're going to use these elementary matrices.